thing on one of my previous videos. Digital transformation and the internet in general has a bigger carbon footprint than the entire aviation industry. And I recently read an article on Wired about how modern websites that are not optimized, they're consuming too much bandwidth and resources, and as such, websites are bad for the planet. Our clients are becoming more and more aware of this. So I want to help you do better. In this video, I will share with you 6 actions you can take today to start optimizing your website, SaaS application, or web ecosystem and make it more sustainable. We look at it from the creative planning stage, but also all the way to the implementation, the infrastructure and the technical coding. This way, you can also contribute to improving the climate crisis and also become a more rounded digital professional with more arrows in your quiver. Let's get to it. Hey, welcome back. I'm Sylvain Reiter, and I'm here to help you become the hero of your next digital project by making better decisions and do your bit for the environment. There are many ways in which websites contribute to greenhouse gas emissions, and it's mostly due to the electricity consumptions required to run the hardware serving those pages. So here are the 6 UX and technical and development changes you can make right now for a positive environmental impact. First would be to plan and optimize UX. So when it comes to building sustainable websites, it's not only the responsibility of the developers or the engineers dealing with the servers to get it right. It starts with the creative research and the design stage. So to reduce the number of page loads, you need to make sure that your end users or customers can find what they're looking for. When it comes from having a good search solution, following intuitive UI patterns, having an optimized information architecture and navigation, as well as very clear content. The second is to move to the cloud. So moving your website to the cloud optimizes the hardware utilization, which will reduce the overall electricity consumption and should also prove more cost-effective in the long term. Even if cloud hosting providers are aiming to be carbon neutral, they're still using fossil fuel to power those data centers. It's not really 100% running on sustainable energy yet. Probably another 5 to 10 years will be there. Third is to optimize your source code. This will involve the entire technical team to speed up the load times and reduce servers' load. Yes, you will tell me that's standard best practices anyway for search engine optimization and performance. It's also what has the biggest impact on sustainability. So it's a good reminder for everyone. This includes working with your front-end developers who will need to write clean HTML code, they need to use optimized images and avoid render blocking JavaScript. Also working with the backend and software engineers who would reduce the number of database requests in the code, minimize the size of the database by only storing what's required, for example, then cache the content of the key pages. Also work with the DevOps engineering team to configure the right servers, enable gzip compression and rotate the logs, and just support the rollout of the next point, which is to use caching where possible. It's the fourth point. There are many tools you can use to speed up the website, such as caching. Cache pages are loaded before users make a request, and it reduces the need to request to reach the servers every time. So when the page is requested, you can use a static version that was preloaded instead of using more energy intensive and dynamically created content on the server side. And caching only works on pages that do not change a lot, so it's important to choose carefully which pages to cache and to not. So work with your team to do that. Fifth is to use a CDN for international reach. The further the data transfer distance between your website and users, the higher the energy consumption. It's just simple math. CDNs, or content distribution networks, are servers that are located all over the world, and they have a copy of your website. So when a user from country X clicks on your site, the nearest CDN serves the page instead of transferring the data halfway around the world. And if your website hosting service doesn't use a CDN, maybe time to switch or to upgrade. And the sixth and last point is to rethink your third-party plugin. So when you run a website, understand why marketers want as much analytics as possible. They want to track every user journey, improve the ROI of their paid campaigns. I get it, you need data to make those decisions. However, those external JavaScript plugins are triggering extra requests and slowing down the overall load time of your platform. So it's time to review if you really need them, or there are most efficient equivalent tools maybe that you could do that. By reducing those, it will also help the compliance towards data privacy of your end users. So those are the main 6 recommendations There are many other measures you can take, obviously, to make your website carbon emission neutral or even carbon positive, which may include complete revamp. Maybe it's too late to change and you need to replace your entire ecosystem. So feel free to reach out if you have any question or if you want a quick free audit like that. However, by implementing the measures I just gave you, you can take your first immediate steps towards a more sustainable web presence. So if you want to start actioning that, and if you're looking for a more sustainable cloud hosting provider, you can watch this video where I compare the biggest three players, AWS, Microsoft Azure, and GCP. I hope you found this video useful, and don't forget to subscribe to keep learning and grow your career in digital. Until next time, keep up the good work, stay safe, and see you soon.